Welcome, dear viewer, on this All Hallows Eve, when most talk of witches and try to deceive, with stories of ghosts and ghastly vampires, macabre enchanters and dreadful desires. But why make up stories when in our own garden we find a mollusc? Most gardeners discard them, but look closer and closer and see how he seethes in creepy white mites that on him do feed. Riccardoella oudemansi, by science they're termed, have these little monsters reputation well earned. For on one single slug they may spend their whole life, drinking its blood and causing its strife, mating less often and dying in winter, just two of the symptoms of this little critter. Slow maturation and less frequent feeding, a prognostication that this mite is breeding. Sucking his blood's not the way that it feeds, but biting the skin and making it bleed. A stylostome is the technical term, and in following lines about it you'll learn. A channel-like structure caused by its saliva. Digestive enzymes that make the hole wider. Around the hole, the skin it does harden, keeping it open, scarring the margin. The middle it melts in too sluggy soup, to be drunk by a mite and his mighty group. Deeper and deeper the hole it is sunk, letting in germs and more noxious gunk. But let's talk of life cycles and how they increase their unholy numbers upon this poor beast. It starts in his lungs where the eggs are secreted, and hatch in a week when their yolk sacs depleted. The six-legged larva crawls over his skin, drinking his blood, letting pathogens in, changing its shape 4 times in 3 weeks, becoming an adult the cycle completes. Should the slug sleep through winter's chill grass, the eggs will stay dormant until the cold's passed, and then in the spring the slug wakes from his slumber, the eggs will all hatch, start the cycle all over. With no way to remove them or burn them with fire, this poor little gastropod soon will expire. But remember, dear viewer, when life seems quite grim, think yourself thankful you're nothing like him. Sleep well, dear viewer, and don't let the bedbugs bite.